HomeShopping basically start 2008 mein maine ki thi. I came up with an idea, why not do something like Amazon or eBay in Pakistan. So HomeShopping, alhamdulillah, it's grown over the last 11 years. We were the only profitable e-commerce venture in Pakistan at this stage. There are a lot of other VC-backed ventures or even family-backed ventures that have come to the market, but they still haven't cracked the code of executing the business in an efficient manner while offering what you claim you're offering. In case of home shopping, I think some of the major challenges that I see is for a business like ours, which are basically trying to grow the business organically in a healthy, profitable manner, is cash flows. Keeping up with cash flows, I think that is definitely one of the biggest challenges. And then not having banks to partner up with you without a collateral, that is another big challenge, which you don't get in most parts of the world. In order to work with a bank in Pakistan, you need a large collateral to support it. So very early on here, I realized that in Pakistan, if I am to build a business, I would need to be standing on my own 2 feet and nobody's gonna come and help me. We wanted to be a healthy, profitable business so that we could fuel our growth using those, right? So, and I think that one main reason has been what has kept us alive for the last 11 years. So I think that focus has helped us. We till date don't work with banks or the other way around, banks don't work with us. So as home shopping is a hybrid marketplace model, our core objective is to enable these retailers, sellers to start selling digitally so that they can explore a new avenue of sales for themselves. We work with them on the merchandising side to update their pricings, they update their range of products that they have, and at the same time we enable them, we even finance them to an extent at times, just so that they could increase their range of merchandising, just so that they could give us better pricing to the consumer. And we even train people who are not traditionally retailers. There are some university graduates that come to us who do not want to go into the job market and they just want to be entrepreneurs for themselves. We help them select a specific niche which we feel can perform well, and we help them build that category. So we partner up in a way with them. Cash on delivery is 90% right now, still overall in the market if you see, and it makes up a large chunk. So we were one of the earliest players to start cash on delivery, and at that time cash on delivery was slightly different, where we would allow people to check their goods and pay for it. So the reason why cash on delivery is still so prominent is because there is a major security risk challenge that people feel while transacting online. I've heard that they're restricting cash on delivery to Rs 10,000 only. And I see that as a challenge because things can't change overnight. They need to change things in stages. And I feel at this stage, restricting any store to just Rs 10,000 is going to be counterproductive for the overall industry. Are a PCI compliant website which stores its data in a specific format as per the compliance guidelines, and I think that's the most we could do at this stage. We have a SSL, we have a team that looks after the security loopholes around the website. So we definitely and always support the fintechs, and the number one reason why we do that is because it makes our life simpler, and because we can then profitably sell smaller commodities, low value commodities. When there's no cash on delivery, the cost of delivery goes down exceptionally, and then all these new possibilities open up. we could not depend on other courier companies to provide the experience that we are trying to provide to our consumers. So once it came to a point where we realized that we cannot be going forward always be thinking that we'll be totally relying on the courier company's performance to give our experience, we felt that piece needs to be fixed, and we fixed it by having our own logistics firm, at least in the major cities. And for the smaller cities right now, we're partnering up with third party couriers to a point where we feel we have sufficient volume to go in and take that to ourselves. So in 2009, we opened up our first retail outlet, which was in Zamzamah. And since then, we've opened up about five different locations in five big cities. That was later converted into then Zoop shops. And every time we moved to a new city and opened up a shop, the orders started exploding from that city, because the shop wasn't just allowing people to walk in, but it was more about people knowing that where to get them if something goes wrong. Right? So just by having a physical presence, people felt more comfortable ordering online. In terms of leveraging social media, we haven't really advertised a lot in respect to home shopping. But we do believe in engagement with our consumers, and I think social media plays a very good role in allowing us to do that. And we want to see home shopping as a platform which could enable such social activity for consumers discussing electronics. So we opened up a blog, and we're going into an area where we would allow people to communicate on the platform. So we're seeing home shopping convert more into a social e-commerce hyper-local marketplace. So home shopping wants to lead the market and be a healthy, sustainable business while we listed on the Pakistan Stock Exchange. These are some of the aspirations that we have moving forward.